welcome to the MBS Show, episode number 194. I am your host, Norman Sanzo. Joining me today is James.
It's over! It's over!
Well, he seems to be...
He's taking it quite nicely than I expected.
True that. And also joining us today is Ro.
Hello, all you happy and distant people.
Hello, how are you doing?
Slowly but surely.
Hi.
I'm back.
Hello.
Sorry about that.
So, how are you doing, James?
Now I'm going for another one. It's over!
Well.
At least he's getting exercise.
And with that new voice, our guest for this week is PuffySmosh. Artist on DeviantArt and number one fan for the show, who also did art for the thingy that we do here. What was it called now? I forgot.
Oh my god.
I'm back again.
Hello.
I'm fine. Get it all out of my system. My rule of threes.
James,
I don't
James.
The rule of threes.
James, did you get enough exercise?
What? No. No, I didn't.
You want to go for round three?
No, I'm fine now.
Rule of threes.
You know what? The ride never ends. Because it's not really over, isn't it? This is just season 5. Season 6 is coming. You could tell me that this was the series finale and I'd be happy. You could tell me there is no ponies in a year and I'll be happy, but... And even if we catch up with all of the episodes, we have the comics, we're gonna have to find something else to talk about, aren't we? Because yep. We always do. That's what we do. That's the thing.
That's
what we do.
They say the ride never ends.
I could cry. I want to get off the ride. I'm my stomach's squishy and I feel sick. I don't want to go down the slope no more, Mom. I want to get off the roller coaster.
This reminds me of a Tumblr comic. It's about this one person joining a fandom. And the person asks, oh, where's the exit? There's no exit.
You can't get in, but you can't get out.
Yes.
Once it got you, it will not let you go.
Indeed.
It's not over.
You go pony, you never go back.
Indeed. But anyway, like I mentioned before, our guest is PuffySmosh, artist on DeviantArt, streamer on Picarto, and quote-unquote artist for the show. So how are you doing?
Technically, I've been a guest before for like one or two times.
No. I highly remember that your only appearance here is on the Christmas episode with Silver Quill.
That was one. The second one was
Where
you and Kyle were basically being my voice.
Oh, God, yeah. That was just interesting. That was an interesting experiment we did. Yeah.
Never doing it again.
Oh, we should do it again. That was awesome.
No. Do you know how long it took me to write?
Get good. Type fast. But anyway, you're on here. We're going to talk about you. But before we officially start, we need to ask you this has been a while. The four important questions.
Do I really have to?
Yes, I forgot. So, number one is, favorite character?
Twilight and Discord, I guess.
Twilight and Discord.
Yeah.
Will you ship it?
Oof.
No, I don't. Aww. I do not. But they have a headcanon together.
True.
And one of the episodes from season 5 actually kind of confirms it.
If you say so.
Aren't you glad?
Twilight and Discord. Funny thing that you mentioned Twilight. Me and Silver kind of did a Twilight talk or more discussion about princesses. So if you're interested, go listen. And for the audience at home who are listening to this, yes, go listen. We talk about it. It was pretty funny because we talk about Princess Zelda from that TV show. You know, the one with Captain N? Yeah. We talk about that one. Also, Discord. That's interesting. Why Discord?
Why not Discord? How weird of a question. Why not Discord?
Yeah. Discord is kind of Technically, I would say that both of these characters are a part of me. Mm-hmm. I'm more of a Twilight, to be honest, but I still have that chaotic side, and Discord is such an amazing character. Plus, you can't forget All Hail John Delancey.
What's your favorite episode?
Still the same as always, the episode from which my biggest headcanon came from, which I wrote a review about, which no one has read except James Senpai. James Senpai noticed me.
Hey, I remember that
Shut
review.
Shut up, too. I'm not your senpai.
I remember the review, I have it bookmarked.
Oh, that's cool. And that is...
It wasn't the review for Bats, right?
No, it was Three's the Crowd.
Three's the Crowd.
Oh.
James Senpai doesn't remember me.
I don't remember half of the things I did this morning. Don't worry. It's not you, it's me.
That's what they all say.
All right. That's what
So anyway, Trees of Crowd. That's a good episode. That's a very good episode.
Actually, it's kind of bad. I actually hated it.
What?
Yes.
Okay,
wait a minute. Would your favorite episode is one that you hate?
Hated.
What made you change your mind on it?
Basically, it's written in the review. Yay! Shameless advertising.
Well, I guess I have to link it then. Yeah, plug. But you know, that blog of yours is just one. You should do more.
I'm not good at writing.
Yes, you got to start somewhere. So the third question is, how did you become a fan of the show?
It's the same as in Christmas episode. Both of them have their own stories. The first one is I found the show through YouTube through 3 hours of doing literally nothing and wasting my life. Mm-hmm. And I just stumbled upon it, and I was like, oh, I played with the toys when I was little. I love the toys. The toys are well made. And so I watched it, and then, yeah, those weren't the ponies that I knew, and I loved it.
All right.
And the fandom, well, on DeviantArt, I wrote in the search MLP just for...
That's not a word!
...and giggles. And I found quite many art pieces because I joined in September of 2012. And because of this wonderful artist, Citra 360, I got to know, well, basically you guys and everyone else. Citra is where I started because I tried to get on his streams and chat with the bronies.
I'm sorry.
Why?
We're terrible people. Says so on the internet.
How dare you talk to me, Norman? That's it. I'm quitting.
Ah, I love messing with you. But anyway, so that's how you became a fan of the show, through, well, YouTubing, Googling on DeviantArt, and just watching streams. Well, that's a pretty normal, right?
Yeah, no comment. Yeah,
true. So
I'm boring.
Hey, trust me, you're not the bored one here. You're not the bored one. I am the bored one. But anyway, what do your family and friends think about your love for said show?
Mostly everyone doesn't care or is fine. Everyone's fine with it, I'd say. Of course, there have been quite humorous things, with how they react and stuff. Heck, my stepdad for a year, he actually teased me and said, "Ooh, look, a pony."
All right.
And yeah, it's fun. It's fun.
Getting teased is part of the experience of becoming a brony or being a fan of this show.
So not always.
It depends. Like for me, I think I did got teased once by a friend. But like I said, teasing is part of the experience. You just take it with a grain of salt and then brush it off. Puff, what do you do in the fandom? Like I mentioned earlier on, but I don't think I did justice. So in your own words, can you describe it to us?
Well, I'm a freelance artist Shameless plug-in. I do commissions. Holiday commissions. They are cheaper prices. Yay.
Yay. Don't worry. This show is all about the shameless plugs. Amy Larson's book is on Amazon. It is amazing. Penny Royal Academy. God. Go buy. It's Christmas, so it will make a very good Christmas present.
Also, I am as well open for commissions, and I do movie reviews with Movies Late. You can check my blog. Norman, we are not doing this.
Yes, we are. Ro, you don't want to plug in?
Yes, I got a beard.
Yes. Well, everybody go home. That's the plug-in to all of the plug-ins. That's it. We're done.
That's it. Show's over. Bye.
No.
Over. Bye.
I wish. But anyway, you were saying?
Yeah, I'm a freelance artist. Mm-hmm. I started actually streaming a week ago. Mm. Well, technically two when you're listening to this. I just do art, I guess. Senpai noticed me.
So, the thing is, you've been doing art for a while now. I've seen your new art gallery and stuff, and your progression has been steadily increasing, and I have to say, it looks good. And
thank you. And just for you guys to know, that a while that he's talking about is 3 years.
Hey, I don't want to promote.
3 years already?
It's been 3 years already.
When did time go?
Well,
I have no idea.
You have to remember that she's still studying, so she's not 24 hours on the computer practicing how to draw. So for 3 years to get where she is now, that's quite an improvement. But you, Ro, you've been doing this for how many now?
Let's see, that was 2 × 5. I don't know, it's been a while.
Yeah, you're
I lost track of time, man. I don't have a calendar, I don't have a watch. Well, I got it on my phone, but I always get distracted by the pretty picture I got as a wallpaper, so.
Yeah, but honestly speaking, like, from my time here, like, almost 4 years, and watching you guys draw and stuff, you guys have been increasingly getting more experience and getting more awesome, including you, James. Like, wow.
Really?
Yeah,
your art is so good. Senpai.
Yeah, everyone, like you guys, like you, Puff, Ro, and James, like I'm just here in the background just looking at it, and I don't do art. All I do
is
this.
Yes, you do.
Well, not much, but all I do is this silly show.
You do vector art. It still kind of counts.
Yeah, we'll see. But anyway, it's not enough about me. It's all about you. So you do the arts. You do have commissions and you do streaming. I do want to carry on, but you know, it's the season. It's almost December. Like when this episode comes out.
I want to wish everyone a happy late Turkey Day.
Turkey Day today.
Turkey Day.
It's not today.
Thursday.
No,
it was. Yeah, it's the last Thursday of November, isn't it?
No, it not today?
No, it's the first Thursday, the last Thursday of every November.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. Yes. I had no idea. I only knew about this like a day ago. I was like, oh, really?
Yeah, same. I actually saw that when someone actually said Happy Turkey Day to me. And this means that I won't rage that there is early Christmas things in the shops. Yes.
Early Christmas thingies. Like, trust me, I've passed that early Christmas thing a while back now. When was it again that we talk about Christmas?
July.
July, was it? Yeah.
When the 25th July.
Yeah, because that that album that was announced to be coming out was announced in July, and then like everybody's like, what?
No.
What are we talking about? Halloween in September? I think that we are following the structure of a TV show where the episodes are always aired out of order.
Yeah, I guess.
I can't think of one. No. Mandopony. You said that the album got released on, it was said that it's going to be released in July, but actually no, those were Christmas toys. The first Christmas toys were in July.
Oh yeah, that was the true. But early November, the album came out, and you know what? I bought the album. I kind of gave a review on it. I highly enjoy it, and I think as a gift from Hasbro to the fans, they put the album "It's a Pony Kind of Christmas" on their YouTube channel for everyone to listen. So it's up there. If you want to play it, just go. I think it's the whole album, if I'm not mistaken.
It is.
Yeah, the whole album. And listen to, man, like, I don't know what to say. It's free. I think, to me, it's Hasbro's gift to us. I highly enjoy Jingle Bells. Jingle Bells is fun.
Hate that song.
What?
Jingle Bells, Batman smells, Robin,
Robin
laid
an egg.
Oh, wait, wrong song.
Puff, have you listened to the album?
Yes, I did. I actually did today. Mm. I added the entire playlist to another Christmas playlist of MLP songs that I have that I made in 2014. No, wait, 13.
Wow. Okay. No comment. Like, to me, I bought this. I like this. Like, this is just for everyone to listen. I hope they leave it up, but there's a high chance they might take it down just because, well, this is for, you know, the holidays. So, maybe holiday next year.
Hmm. Hopefully.
James, have you listened to it?
No, I have not. Call me old-fashioned. I don't listen to Christmas carols outside of the season.
Well, it is going to be the season, so yay.
Yeah, but okay, fine. But, dude, like, it's bad luck. I don't want to listen to something that is going to bring me bad luck. I am very... What's the word? Superstitious. Superstitious when it comes to that kind of thing. Yeah, no, really. I don't know how it's spread out is over here in my country, but I grew up with the idea that if you listen to Christmas songs outside of Christmas season, that's not a good idea. That's not good. So I don't listen to Christmas carols. I'm saving. But I heard that it's really good. So I'm surely gonna enjoy it when the Christmas season appears, which is in like 3 days.
Okay. But you know, you should have taken the mantra of the nostalgia critic. Just listen to it whenever.
Oh, that's what he does. Yeah. I don't mind. That's what he does. This is what I do.
Yeah, true. So, talking about what you do and what he does, Puff, what do you do to draw?
I draw?
Yeah, maybe that segue didn't came out right, but what application do you use to draw and what tools do you use to draw?
I use paint tools, Sai. Yeah, that's a thing. And then I also use a Genius tablet from 3 years ago. Wow, it's old. I don't like the... If anyone wants to buy a vacuum pen, I know they have new models or something. Mm-hmm. I have no idea how they feel, but I have the old version. And oh my god, it made me cry.
Oh,
so bad?
It was so bad. It's like, take a piece of plastic and rub it against another piece of plastic.
Oh, dear, I think I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Yeah. I can't. I'm like rarity. I'm very picky.
Oh my.
Hey, look, fair enough. I mean, when you have to do a picture, when you're going to do some artwork, you want to be as comfortable and feeling as nice as you want. Because you get distracted, you can get, like, you know, little nuances. Even a slight itch can ruin an entire drawing. So you want to draw with something that you're comfortable with. You don't want to draw with something that is going to give you some grief.
Yeah, but remember that one of the co-hosts of the MBS show, Kick, or Kick Ass King, check him out on DeviantArt.
Plug.
All the plugs. Beards. Yeah, he draws with a pen small. I have no idea how. It amazes me.
Well, it's something that people get used to because when I started with a Graphite 4.
Never heard of it.
Wacom, Graphite 4. That's older than you guys. So,
hey,
yeah.
I know I'm young.
Yeah, you guys use the quote-unquote Intuo small and whatnot. I use a Graphite.
What?
that's how
Norman,
old school I am.
Norman, yo. I use a tablet from 3 years ago, and it's not even Wacom.
Which, no comment. It's preferences, it's tools of the trade. Like, I recently bought a new mouse because I wanted to get more efficient, so yay.
So, technically, I would say that it's not about the tool you use. Heck, even Sai is a free program and it doesn't give you all of the amazing things like text and opacity, which I think it does now, weirdly enough. I have no idea how. And it's just the way you learn how to draw and use the advantages each program gives you. You use whatever you have, because I even have a friend who draws with a mouse. And she draws beautiful art.
Oh, true. We all know that. I mean, we all who do art or do creative things, we work with what we have and we use our limitations to the fullest. Isn't that right, James?
Absolutely. If this was a perfect world, I will have two Wacom Cintiq tablets with their screen. I could paint on them. I would have three monitors and everything like that. It's not a perfect world. I have
share one with me.
No, I'm totally, I totally give you one. If this was a perfect world, I will totally give you one. Give a Cintiq for all of my artist friends. But
yay.
I only have one monitor, one laptop, and my Wacom Intos, and I do all I want and I can with these three things.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is true. We use what we have. As limited as our mediums are, we use them. To the full potential until they break, and then we have to buy another one.
I'm actually getting jealous of you because you have a laptop and I don't even have that.
Trust me, the laptop thing is not awesome.
My laptop cannot move.
How?
My laptop, because I cannot fold it because the screen part of the laptop is cracked. So if I try to fold it down, it will open up and definitely ruin the screen. And the Wi-Fi connector doesn't work anymore, so I have to have it connected with our Ethernet cable. So I cannot move it around. You can call it a laptop, but it's really not a laptop. It's a piece of...
That's not a word!
It's what it is. So, yeah, I cannot use it. I know, that's not
but
a word.
But it still works!
Oh, yeah, it still works, but it's stationary. It's kind of a...
Oh, no, yeah, it works. Unless it gets the jitters, and then every now and then gets a blue screen of death. So, yeah, but no, yeah, it still works, positive, yeah. I want to throw this piece of trash in the garbage and then get a new one.
Yeah.
God.
But still, we work with what we have. And
yes.
I, personally for me, I am working on Audacity, of all things. Audacity is a free program and it's, quote unquote, not the stablest thing in the world. But hey, I'm working with it and I do edit on the show to what you're listening to now, so yay. But still, like I said, limitations.
And dude, Audacity is actually a pretty good program.
Oh, trust me, some podcasters I heard do not like it because it crashes.
Yeah, but okay, many people use Paint Tools High because they don't like to use Photoshop because it crashes. I use Photoshop and it has only crashed on me twice in like 3 years.
Well, like I said,
Paint Tools I haven't crashed on me. I think it crashed on me once, and that was because I didn't have enough memory to finish a piece. And that's it. That's it.
What I actually wanted to ask, Norman, have you ever had problems with Audacity?
Thankfully, no. But I've heard other podcasters who are way experienced than me. But yeah, that's them. This is me. We all have different systems, so we're not the same. But like I said, each individual has different ways of working, different tools, and different advantages. Other than that, Puff, how do you get your style? What's your inspiration?
I don't have any.
Oh, you do. You do.
I don't know.
You're not inspired by anyone or anything?
To be honest, no, I don't think so.
Really? No? Not anime or manga?
I like anime. I want to draw an anime style. I just can't.
Oh.
You want to animate?
I actually do. Even though it's going to be a pain and I'm going to hate it, I think.
Oh, you're going to love it.
I can hear the undertone.
No, you're going to love the whole process. Like, working on animation is stressful and just hard work, but once it's done, you'll love it.
Yeah, the thing is that what kind of keeps me away is line art. And I hate line art. It takes me so long to do.
Mm. You're not the only one, sister.
Yes.
Anyway, moving on to another person who does creative things is Lauren Faust. And sad to say that she's no longer working on Medusa.
Yeah, what they always say, creative differences.
It seems that Sony Pictures Animation and her and Lauren are, well, they don't see eye to eye and they split. So I was really excited on the whole idea. I really wanted to see this.
I have, to this day, I've heard of Medusa. I've heard that Lauren Faust is working on it. To this day, I have no idea what it is.
Do you know what Medusa is?
You know the mythology behind the Medusa?
Yes.
The Medusa was, it was a Greek myth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah, it's a Greek, it's a creature from Greek mythology that had, it was a woman with the body, of a woman, and the upper body was a woman and the legs of a snake, so it has a snake tail. And it had, its hair was not actually hair, it was lots and lots of snakes. And when it looked at you, she'll turn you into stone, thus killing you.
Mm. Yes, now, I've actually heard of her.
Yeah, yeah. If you have seen that, terrible Clash of the Titans remake with the guy from Avatar, yes, you might have seen the Medusa. That's the thing. Mm. And Lauren Faust was making a movie based off of that character. And then
there's nothing more to say. It's one of those cool ideas that Lauren had, but I don't know where.
But was it her idea?
You have to remember that most of Lauren's works are girl power. It empowers girls. They have this sense of this female character is kick-ass. They really are awesome. But
that's not really empowering.
I don't know.
Not really empowering. No, I think that's just
really good characteristic.
Making a good character, making a good female character, which is something that very rarely happens.
Yeah. But we have to see what they do. I mean, like, if I see the trailers and it looks good and entertaining, I'm going to say it's cool.
Hmm? I'm going to play devil's advocate here. Right, I'm not going to be a Lauren Faust sucker like almost everybody else is in the fan. There is a misunderstanding when it comes to waging the talent of Lauren Faust when it comes to creating seasons 1 and 2 of MLP. Mm-hmm. Now, she was a piece of it. She wasn't the only one. She wasn't the only one involved in the creation of MLP. There was Jason Thyssen. There was Rob Renzetti. We also had Jim Miller was in the storyboards of seasons 1 and 2, and then he became a director for seasons 3, 4, and 5. Mm-hmm. It's not just the one man army, or in this case, one woman army. So Lauren Faust leaving didn't cause that big of an impact in the grand scheme of things, because if she was that big of a deal, MLP wouldn't exist right now, and they wouldn't go for their 6th season and the first MLP movie and the 3rd Equestria Girls movie. Now, so I like for the stuff that she has done in the past, but whenever someone says we have decided to not keep working due to creative differences, that's not just because Sony Pictures was. You know how Sony Pictures are, every other production company. We don't like the things you are doing here. Get out. That also means that Lauren Faust was pushing forward with an idea that wasn't accepted by the studio. Mm-hmm. And usually when that happens, you have to go, because none of the parties wants to relent.
Either or, really, because it's not one side, it's both sides, really.
It's both sides, but the same way that the studios want to get their money and they want to get their paycheck, the artistic part of the movie, that is the creators, they can be very pig-headed and stubborn point of saying, if this project doesn't go the way I want, I'm walking.
Oh.
That's what happened with Brave.
Oh.
That's what happened with the first director that they brought to Brave. I don't remember her name, but they fired her and they brought in another guy. And you know what happened a couple of months later after the movie was released? That the director that they fired, she won an Oscar because they did fire her, but they didn't remove her name from the credits. So, yeah, like, okay, that's how it works. It's ridiculous. Oh. But whatever she has done in the movie, she has, I'm pretty sure it's going to be left there. Mm-hmm. Maybe the new ideas will not be applied, but guys, remember, this is not just Sony Pictures' fault. Take into account that we have a big ego, artists. Mm-hmm. We do. Oh, we so do. And if we don't see things the way that we want, and we don't like to swallow our pride and keep moving forward, we are asked very politely to leave. And if we insist, then we have to be pushed out of the door by the bodyguards. That's usually what happens. Mm, you need to swallow your pride.
Yeah, but usually, not always.
Mm, true.
That's why I say usually. There is many projects that have been moving forward by the director or the writer or the producer doing what the studio is telling them to do.
Mm-hmm. And yeah. a funny story, though, is with the Fast and the Furious movie, because those movies are just, well, machismo action movies for the summer. And Vin Diesel really loves the movie. Like, he really wants to do those movies. And he is willing to get a pay cut just to do those movies. So, yeah, it's a give and take thing.
Well, not anymore.
Depends on which part of the series.
I'm confusing it with the Riddick series.
Yeah.
But he does love both of them. Yeah, but did you know the story behind how he's able to keep making Riddick movies? Is that when they were making Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift, they were trying to connect it with the rest of the movies, and they had this preview audience to tell them what they think, like test audiences, like, what do you guys think of the movie? And everybody was saying, oh, the movie sucks because none of the characters of the original movies are in it. So they called Vin Diesel and they were like, hey, Vin, can you like record a little cameo for the end of the movie just to appease the fans? And Vin Diesel was like, sure, if you give me the rights to the Riddick movies. So they gave him the rights to the Riddick movies, and he did the cameo. So now he's in the possession of those rights, so he can keep making as many Riddick movies as he wants. Because if Vin Diesel likes something more than Fast and Furious, is the character of Riddick.
Nice.
Amazing.
Nice. Yeah. And that's how you trick a studio into doing what you want.
And oh, by the way, also, Vin Diesel is a major nerd.
Oh, yeah, he plays Dungeons & Dragons.
I know, D&D nerd.
But he made friends with Judi Dench, because Judi Dench was a dungeon master on one of the D&D games that he was on. And they made friends. That's how Judi Dench came to work in one of the Riddick movies.
Nice.
Yeah. Can we just talk about Vin Diesel for the rest of the podcast? It's so much fun. I love that guy.
You know what? Okay, I'm going to open this up to the audience. If you guys listen to the latest quote-unquote MBS show review, which is really titled the MBS show discussion podcast show, whatever, we talk about Mrs. Twilight. So now, if you guys want us to talk about Vin Diesel, do put it in the comments so we can
Are you going to put me in the dungeon again so I cannot talk about Vin Diesel, Norman?
No, maybe I'll put Silver in there.
It was dark and cold and crummy and there
you
was a rat
in
there. I
with you?
Shut up, I don't care. It was dark and cold. I want a blanket. You didn't feed me.
No comment. But you know what? Okay.
Can I ask, if you're doing the Vin Diesel episode, can we take the next episode for Jason Statham?
Jason Statham?
Oh, Jason Statham. Ah, the goblin.
We say, in Latvian, we really say his name as Jason Statham.
Oh, you know what? Okay, back to the audience again. If you want us to talk about Jason Statham, put it in the comments and we'll do it.
In my country, we call him the transporter.
Yes, indeedy. Talking about your country, James. Talking about your country. It seems that the Mandopony magazine for your country and all of Europe has the Apple Bloom figure.
Yay!
Oh, it's not out on the news agents yet. Not that I have checked. I'll have to check next week. But those figures are ridiculously good. For the price that they put on them, dude, like, no shame. I'm going to the news agents and getting it. They are so sweet.
True. The only bad
Let's
thing.
Let's buy one for Lycan.
Okay. No. No.
No. But we don't know what he'll do with it.
The only bad thing about this is there's no cutie mark.
Well, of course not. This is old. Dude, by the time that we actually are not that bad when it comes to the season being aired at the same time as in the US, but I think the latest episode that came out was episode 15. No, it was the Reddit Investigates episode. That
really
was the latest
now?
Episode. That,
for your country?
Yeah, in my country.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah, like, which is unbelievable because we didn't get any episodes of MLP until 2012. We had the first 3 seasons aired in like the time span of 3 months.
Wow, cheating.
Do you have any idea how that messes you up? You don't have a clue. It's ridiculous. And then, bam, season 4.
Wow. Oh, wow. That's impressive. But, Puff, have you seen those magazines in your country?
I have. Really? They are ridiculously pricey.
How much is it for you? Like, James, how much is yours?
€4.
€4. What about you, Puff?
Yeah, same here.
Oh,
the thing is that... What?
€6 in my home country.
Really?
What?
Okay. I was looking for those books I wanted to give you, James, and god darn it, it's €6-7. Like, what?
Okay, good. Don't spend your money. That's ridiculous. That's stupid. What?
I mean, I don't understand. I mean, it's just not... It doesn't have a figure or anything. It's just one of those childish ABC 1, 2, 3 books with just a few... with a lot of stickers.
I like those books, but they are super, super pricey. That's ridiculous. What the hell?
Puff, you were saying?
I don't get it.
Home country!
Go ahead, Puff. Potato
Land. Basically, it is the same price because Latvia is also now in euros, mm-hmm. sadly. But when I was a kid, I used to read tons of comics, and one of them was Witch series. You don't know them, probably.
I do. I've seen the cartoon.
Yay, somebody knows what I'm talking about. And basically, they cost... let me convert it in euros in my brain real quick. They were about... Well, they are a euro with something.
Mm-hmm. A euro.
Euro, yeah. And the thing is... That was like 10 years ago. Not that much, but still. It's like, I'm used to those prices. I'm used to seeing everything cheap because, I usually don't buy stuff. And now, after all this long time, when I go in and just look at how long, not how long, but how much,
mm-hmm.
A TV thing with what's on the TV
mm-hmm.
Costs. I'm just surprised and I just walk away. It's that much.
Time's changing, inflation and whatnot. Like, that's normal. That's just...
Then stop, please. Someone make it stop. I want cheap prices.
Since we're off track, why don't we go to space?
Because ponies.
No. Are you talking about the guy who etched his pony OC on the side of the space station or something like that?
It's more of a supply. If you've seen The Martian, you know what that is because they tried to send him food. But yeah, he drew his OC onto the supply box. And that's just cool.
Well, if you see The Martian, you know that NASA is full of nerds. So,
yes!
Because it is full of nerds. That was the beauty of The Martian. It's like it's 2 hours of nerds,
but
absolute
it's good
total
nerds.
Space nerds. No, I dude, I love that movie. It's one of my favorite
it's good
movies.
Nerds.
Of the year. And it's fantastic. It's like yes, the nerds will save the future. I love this movie.
Even the bad guy is a nerd.
I swear, I could have made a movie when I for the first time when I went into a magic shop. Just the look on their faces It was the most hilarious thing ever.
Okay, so
what is that beautiful creature? They call them women. We heard them on the lands of fortune, dude. I didn't know
the
real.
James. It should be like this. Like, oh my god, it's Chandra, or Liliana, or even Nisa.
Oh, dude. What does the instruction manual say about this? There is no part in the instruction manual that says anything about this. We're screwed, man. We're screwed.
You know what the funniest part was? Mm-hmm. One of the guys said, "You know why girls should play magic?
Why?
Because you can get to know cool guys."
Oh, really?
Well, Norman and James play Norman, magic,
you got,
so
you got away with what you wanted. You finally killed Norman. Good.
Yes.
We're free, guys. We're finally free. We can go.
I'm taking over this show.
Oh no! Please, Norman, come back.
Aww.
Oh yes. What? I hit my name.
We were talking about space, and the guy who put his OC on the... Yeah, before they would put Princess Luna or Celestia or something dignified, but now we put an OC. Great, good. Fantastic. Hey. Awesome. Next time I go to a cinema, I'm going to make movies late stickers so I can put them on the doors of every cinema that I go to.
Do it!
I'm not going to do that. That's vandalism. I'm not going to.
If you say so. But from what I learned from my days of the Dreamcast, graffiti means freedom.
Just a radio!
Yeah, they also give you a warning before you play the game saying, if you do graffiti, you're going to get busted by the police, so stop that.
Oh. Okay, then.
Unless you're a licensed artist who has the permission to draw on the wall.
Yeah. Okay. If you have a permission, then it's fine.
Mm-hmm. Remember, kids always ask permission before you do stuff.
Mm-hmm. True.
Or first do it and then ask for an apology, because that's a lot easier than asking for permission.
Draw. Yes? Draw. Shut up.
Not helping there, but still, I agree. I think Silver would too.
What was it? I don't trust someone who has died more times than Kenny from South Park.
True.
You've been keeping count.
Thanks, James.
Yes.
Thanks.
Well, considering the amount of reviews that he has done and the amount of times that he's got killed, impaled, burned alive, chased by an angry mob or something, I think, yeah, he has died more times than Kenny from South Park.
True. And also best friends with Sombra.
Yeah. Well,
I wonder if he's not working on the Die Hard now.
I don't know. But still, what else can we say? Like, this guy who works at NASA, who is a brony, who has his OC. I don't know what to say. It's an OC.
That guy is living the dream. Yeah, this character lives where no other OC has went.
First, I wonder, what are his superiors going to say? Second, do you think that maybe the paint will wear off of the side of that container, whatever it is, turn into a...
No, ball
of paint or something, go at the speed of light and then kill some poor astronaut in the way. You have any idea the damage that a single drop of paint can make to a space, to a rocket?
Wow.
That's actually pretty serious. Yeah.
It is. There's actually an anime about that.
We don't need anime.
What was it called? God damn it. I really enjoy that anime. I've been watching it. I watched it quite a while ago.
And you know exactly what I'm talking about here, Puffy.
Yes, amazing.
So, you know,
fascinating.
I think you're going to put something in the space station. I hope that at least he got it approved by his superiors. So his superiors are the one to blame, and no, not him.
Yeah. So the anime is called Planets with... There's a weird E between T and S, so...
Mm.
It's weird. Norman is going to put it in the description.
I'm pretty sure he likes that.
What? Hey, don't make it wrong. Don't make it wrong. Jerk.
I just understood what you... Oh.
Norman is going to put it in.
Oh, shush you.
Bringing a really old reference back... I'm not plug and play, thank you.
Oh god. Oh god.
James,
no.
If you don't remember that, shame on you.
I do remember. But you're still a lot of fun.
No, stop. but anyway, I
and you rattle when you giggle.
Thanks
for interactivity, 3 ports, all compatible, USB.
Thanks for breaking the guest.
Don't worry, I think she's on warranty.
It's okay, I'm pretty sure she likes it.
Oh god. I don't know.
And now, on the MBS show After Dark.
I don't know who's worse, you or Silver.
If you wanted to make sure that nobody ever comes back on this show as a guest, except for the people that we sexually assault, then yeah. Bring me in.
Oh, wow. This is going to be fun.
Ah, oh, come on.
That's what she said.
Ro, your job here is sealed in stone.
That's what she said.
Hard rock stone, I see.
Alrighty then. So, we reached... So we reached the end of the news. There's no more news to account to. Besides that, we're recording on the day that season 5 is ended. Really awesome show. Unfortunately, we can't talk about it because, well, if we talk about it here, we don't have any fuel to talk about it on the review show. So, yeah.
Besides, it is better to let the hype die down.
Yeah.
Sure. Because, like, if you were to ask me right now, I'd say, best series finale ever, oh my god! But it's not.
Yeah, there's problems.
It's not. There's things that are worth to talk about. There's things that are worth discussing. But this is not place. We're going to talk about them when we get to the actual reviews, which we are so far behind.
Oh, yeah.
And I have nobody else to blame but myself. I feel like I kind of, like, waked you down, guys.
Oh, no, come on. Like, you were busy. You had something to do.
I was with Bronnie Scott and all that. Should we talk about Bronnie Scott?
Oh, yeah, we should.
Yes!
We should talk about Bronnie Scott, actually, because, wow. I can tell you from the convention floor how everything was.
Oh, please do, man, right? Please do.
Well, it was, without a hint of a doubt, the best convention experience I've ever had in my life.
Mm.
Like, wow. No joke. Yeah, seriously. Liked it. It was way more enjoyable than back. It was way more... entertaining and way more, I liked it more and I enjoyed it more interactive. It felt better because, something happened that has never happened to me.
Which is?
I suddenly realized that despite what some people might have done or said about me in the past, and despite the bad experiences that I have had in the past, the amount of people that appreciate and like what I do, is always going to be bigger than the amount of people that don't.
Then bye.
No, shut up. No, it's like, it's that kind of thing, is that, it's weird to explain, because you have this big community and you have all of these other artists that are fantastic and they are great and they are massive. And then you have the other artists that are less known and, they have their own fans and everything. And then you have the other artists that are trying to start and get things going. And then there's me. Because I am like below. I don't consider myself that big. And going there, these guys, every person that came to the table, every person that came to me and sent something nice, they made me feel like I was a rock star.
Wow. And
The whole event was super well planned. From... Hour zero, it was very tight. From what I saw, it was very well tied together, very well prepared. I was rooming at the hotel where the convention was taking place. So I saw a bit of behind the scenes, how things were going to get planned and everything. And it seemed like they knew what they were doing. It seemed like they knew what they were planning. And by the end of the con, it was super successful. The charity did make more money. The charity for the Children's Hospice Association of Scotland did a lot more money than last year's charity drive. Like, last year we didn't reach 1,000. I think this year we surpassed it.
Wow, that's awesome.
the charity piece that I gave to sell for the charity auction was sold for like £50, which was great. Matt Munchkin's painting, which she had to redo because her hard drive died on her and she had to redo a new painting, it was sold for £99, which is fantastic. And they made a huge banner to announce Rock Nessie, signed by all the musicians and myself because I did the artwork on it. And they sold it at the, they auctioned it at the Rock Nessie concert. And they auctioned it for like £130. That was fantastic.
Wow.
And it felt so good to introduce the banner because they called me on stage and I was like, oh no, I don't want to go on stage.
Wow.
I had to end up doing. And even though I spent the entire convention behind a desk, except for the artist panel that I did with Maddie, which went super well, by the way, we got a bunch of questions.
Ooh, wow.
And yeah, and we got a bunch of questions and I have to say, I felt so minuscule when people started showing up and asking questions and all that. I'm like, this is all because of the artwork that we do. This is all because of the things that we do in this community, which when you're sitting here in an office that is half lit, you're all alone, you only have the means to socialize is Skype, because I don't really have all that many friends in like offline. And suddenly you go out and you see all of this. It's like, wow, it renewed my energies to go back behind to the drawing board and make some new pictures.
That's so awesome to hear.
Yeah, it's definitely the best convention experience I've ever had. Cool. Lots of cool people, very great. The ML Arson panel, I missed it, but from what I heard, yeah, I missed it because I was selling at the table. But from what I saw, it was really cool.
Oh,
it was really fun, and it was really funny.
I wish I could be there to talk to Larson again. Like, hey, Larson, remember me?
From what I heard, he was very tired at the beginning. He was like super sleep deprived and like early morning rested by that. But there was a running joke with everybody screaming Larson throughout the panel. So yeah, something tells me that it must have been one of the best experiences of the convention. You're gonna have to ask someone else to narrate it though. Sorry,
it's cool.
But yeah,
cool.
Left and right, absolute best. Brandy convention going experience. No, hell, screw that. Best convention going experience I've ever had.
Wow. Awesome.
Like, in general. I want to repeat next year. I cannot wait.
I've never been to a convention.
Yeah. Puff, you have to find one that's close to you or.
There is one in Riga. There is one in Riga. Yes, I am.
How far is that from the Netherlands?
Very far.
Oh, because there is Hearth's Warming Con where Sketchy is going and I am going to be going as well. I just need to get my airplane ticket. Everything else is taken care of.
Wow, awesome.
Yes.
Try talking to come to Latvia, please.
If they
there is a convention here.
Latvia,
I wish.
You know what? If there is a convention in Latvia, tell them to bring me as a guest and I will definitely show up.
Okay. But the thing is that sadly, the tickets for that convention, which is Unicorn and its winter version, WinterCon, the ticket to Unicorn is €35, I think, for one day, maybe two.
Wow, that's pricey.
Yes, because it's a small convention. Not many people come because Latvia, but hey, it's convention.
Yay! Well, no matter what it is, no matter where you are, it's the experience of meeting people and the environment. The most important part of any convention is to have fun.
I want to have fun with my friends.
Well, make new friends. Like the most important part is the experience. It's the journey that matters.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Even though it feels very sad at the end to leave everybody behind. Because it's like, no, I feel at home here and I want to go back. I want to keep talking about ponies 24/7.
Oh, true. Or play Monopoly.
It felt great. Actually, we didn't play Mandopony while we were over there. It was sad.
Good. That game broke friendships and
that game is awesome. What are you talking about? You talk about that. The one who won Monopoly while we were at back.
Yeah, I know.
You
Norman.
You,
Yes.
Let me tell you, Monopoly is actually one of my favorite games. Mm-hmm. I just, in the entirety of these 16 years, I've only played it 3 times, and we never finished the game. And I'm heartbroken. It literally breaks my heart because I can't play board games because no one wants to play with me.
Puff, look at this guy giggling.
Puff, just something interesting.
Norman, you're such an...
That's not a word!
No, it's not that. Like, I need to say something. Shut up, you! I kill you! But anyway, Puff, there's something interesting. If you want to play board games with a few friends online, there's this...
Online is not the same thing.
Listen to me.
Playing cards against humanity is not...
I'm not saying that. Like, there's a game on Steam that's called Tabletop Simulator.
Oh my god, you don't say. I've never heard of it before. Totally not sarcasm at all.
Oh, my sarcasm meter 3000 is breaking. Ah!
I don't understand sarcasm, so I'm going to stay out of this.
Yeah, but no, still, the board game, the game on Steam is called Tabletop Simulator, and it simulates a lot of games. The one that me, Ro, and Kyle play was something called Dead of Winter. It's a zombie kind of board game.
I know that one. It's a cool one. It looks so good in real life.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
But, Puff, do you have friends to play it with?
I do. They just don't want to play.
Well, we do. We want to play. So, yeah.
I don't care about you. Get out of here. What am I doing here?
But anyway, if you're interested, you should get that game and play with us. And we can also play Monopoly, too. I think we're digressing.
I have no money. Goodbye, my commissions.
Oh, wow. Good segue. But anyway, before we leave, is there anything you want to promote, Puff?
Buy my commissions.
I'll put it in the show notes, too.
But to be honest, the commissions are actually for a lifetime goal of mine. So I'm kind of saving all of the money, and it's going to go on a good purpose, which is a life goal of mine. And also, I made the holiday commissions because I wanted to give it the opportunity to give someone happiness through my weird art that I've done for 3 years now. Yeah, it's kind of like if you want a gift for a friend or family, like one of my friends did. He commissioned me to do a Christmas gift, early Christmas gift, and it's like it's wonderful to spread this joy at the time of spreading happiness and being generous. Basically, the rarity time.
All right, understandable.
Also, the rarity song is the best one from the album.
Technically, that's not rarity, that's Kazumi Evans. So,
Kazumi Evans doing the voice of rarity.
Don't care, it's still rarity.
Is Kazumi Evans the voice, the voice of rarity when she's singing?
Yeah, but also the voice of Luna too, so... Yeah.
Yeah, well, of course.
Yeah. But anyway,
2-1 for the price of one.
Indeed. But anyway, we reach our end, so there's nothing more. This is quite a long episode. I'm happy with this. So if you guys have any questions, concerns, or suggestions for the show, you can contact us at mbshow@gmail.com or put it in the comments below. I read them, really. And you can also reach us on the Twitters. The show's Twitter account is at mbshow. Sweetiebot will read the Twitters and retweet stuff that's interesting, and also try to wish you guys a happy holiday, which she did with the Turkey Day. I don't know why. I kind of help out by reblogging it, so yay. And also me, you can reach me at Norman Sanzo. I tweet about toys, food, and whatever tickles my fancy. And tickling my fancy now is just this holiday season with the food and whatnot. Foods are nice. Yum. James, what about you, man?
Well, I haven't promoted my stuff over here in a while, and I don't think I need to. You guys know what I do, you guys know what I do, and that's it. You know who I am, you know what I do. I am all over the place.
Alright.
Working on movies late, doing stuff, season's over. I cannot wait to record another review show! Oh my god! Norman, get silver next week. We need to review something. I miss talking with that guy so much. You have no idea.
All right. And
oh, my God.
What about you, man?
You can find me on my Twitter at @religious_art, where I tweet webcomics of various artists and creators, or my Tumblr, religiousart.tumblr.com, or our gallery, thereligiousgalleries.tumblr.com, where we reblog all other artists' cool creations and whatnot. And, yeah, and my DeviantArt guy, religious.deviantart.com. That is so much religious. I have an ego problem, guys.
Oh, wow. All right.
I put my name on everything. Last night I called my freaking team mug, the religious mug.
Brother Senpai.
The next thing you know, I'm going to be putting beers in everything. Oh, wait, I already started that.
Oh, God, no. What about you?
Senpai.
Yes.
Oh,
you're a potato.
Potato Senpai.
Potato Senpai.
Well, what about you, Puff? Where can they reach you?
Well, I am old school, because I can apparently only be on one social media, and that is DeviantArt. You can find me at PuffySmosh.DeviantArt.com, and I've been starting to stream, and I have no idea when I'm streaming, so you should give me a follow there on Picato.tv/PuffySmosh.
What about the Tumblrs? I know you do have one.
I have many. I have like three.
Okay. I'm not going to talk about that one. That's personal, so okay, yeah. Well, what about the Twitters? You have a Twitter too.
I have a Twitter too, yes. I haven't posted. It's like, I'm telling you, I can't be in the different kinds of social medias. Heck, I can't even stay on Facebook for long.
Play game, I want points.
Of course you want the points.
I want a life, come on. and also please subscribe on iTunes, YouTube, and Stitcher Radio, and also like our Facebook page. And you can also catch us on PonyOverLife.com. Yes, we're all over the place. Please do give us a good rating on the iTunes, because it helps us help you help us. And links are in the show notes. What else can I say? I think that's the end. I'm babbling right now. So I have been Norman Sanzo.
I have been James Corck.
I'm Religious Rhymes with Delicious.
I am Puffy, the Puffy Smosh of Smushiness and Smushes. Yay.
Alright, that's new. Anyway, we'll join us next week for another awesome, fun-packed, cool episode of the MBS show, where we derp a lot. That's our motto now, we derp a lot.
Bro, warning, may not contain awesomeness or happiness or anything like that.
But may contain nuts.
And beers.
Lots of nuts. Yeah.
Alright. Bro, take us out.
Thank you all so much for listening. Subscribe for more podcasts that we've done. And as always, we will see you on the next podcast.
See you guys later. Bye-bye.
Have a good one, everybody.
Cheers.